Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today I am going to share with you a very interesting lesson. It's based on a story of a king, Tamerlan. So before we go into the contents of the lesson, let's watch this video for a moment.
Hello, my name is Amir Timur. And I was born in Transoxiana in 1336, that's present-day Uzbekistan. And I led my horde of nomadic warriors all across Central Asia, conquering the Mamluks of Egypt and Syria, the Ottoman Empire, and the Delhi Sultanate. By the time I died in 1405, I had gone well on my way to achieving my goal of restoring the ancient Mongol Empire. I died in 1405, and history remembers me as Tamerlane.
ये कहानी है तिमूर की, जिसे दुनिया तैमूर के नाम से जानती है। इसने तुर्कों और मंगोलों पर अच्छी खासी जीत दर्ज की थी और फिर पर्शिया में बनाया तैमूर साम्राज्य। तैमूर का जन्म हुआ 9 अप्रैल 1336 में, जगह का नाम बर्लस, जो कि ट्रांसोक्सियाना में है। तैमूर ने आगे जाकर पश्चिम, दक्षिण और मध्य एशिया में जबरदस्त तरीके से लड़ाइयां जीती। इजिप्ट और सीरिया के मामलुक्स को हराकर इसने अपना एक अलग मकाम बना लिया। दिल्ली सल्तनत पे भी इसने जबरदस्त हमला किया था। तैमूर हमेशा ये चाहता था कि चंगेज खान का मंगोल साम्राज्य पुनः स्थापित किया जाए, और इसी मुहिम में इसने ईरान, मामलुक और ओतमान को हरा दिया। तैमूर की फौज से बहुत लोग डरते थे, ऐसा अनुमान लगाया गया इसने करोड़ों लोगों को मार दिया। ये वो वक्त भी था जब बहुत लड़ाइयां चला करती थीं, खास तौर पे समरकंद के इलाके में। तैमूर लंग के बर्थ डेट को लेकर भी कुछ लोगों का मानना है। इसका जन्म दरअसल 8 अप्रैल 1336 में हुआ था। तैमूर के माने होते हैं लोहा। जब तैमूर 8 साल का ही था, तब इसकी माँ और इसके भाइयों को बंधक बनाकर समरकंद ले जाया गया था, और ये काम मंगोल सेना ने किया था। बचपन से ही तैमूर ने अपनी एक छोटी सी फौज तैयार कर ली थी, जो कि आने जाने वालों को लूट लिया करती थी, खास तौर पे जानवर। तैमूर की जिंदगी से जुड़ी कुछ और भी बड़ी अनोखी दास्तानें हैं कि एक बार ये एक भेड़ चुराने गया तो इसे 2 तीर लगे, एक इसकी दाहिने टांग में लगा, दूसरा इसके दाहिने हाथ में, जिसकी वजह से इसकी 2 उंगलियां कट गई। कुछ लोगों का मानना यह है कि जब ये सिस्तान के खान के यहाँ काम किया करता था, तब इसे चोटें आई थीं और इसी वजह से इसका नाम पड़ा था तैमूरलेन। तैमूर ने अपनी बादशाही तो कायम कर ली, लेकिन जैसे ही इसकी मौत हुई, उसके बाद वो राजपाट भी खत्म हो गया। लोहे जैसा सख्त बादशाह तैमूरलंग का राज्य मोम की तरह पिघल गया।
This class is meant for the students of Green Hills Experimental School, and today we'll be discussing about a story which comes from English textbook for class 3. Dear students, the topic that I have chosen to share with you is the lesson number 6 in your textbook on page number 42. Its name is Try Again. This story is written by James Baldwin, and let's start. This is an interesting story. It reminds us that we should not lose hope and we should never give up. We should keep trying until we achieve the desired results. So the story goes like this. There was once a famous ruler of Tartary whose name was Tamerlane. Like Alexander the Great, he wished to to become the master of the whole world. So he raised a great army and made war against other countries. He conquered many kings and burned many cities. But at last his army was beaten, his men were scattered, and Tamerlane fled alone from the field of battle. For a long time he wandered in fear from place to place. His foes were looking for him. He was in despair. He was about to lose all hope. One day he was lying under a tree, thinking of his misfortune. He had now been a wanderer for 20 days. He could not hold out much longer. Suddenly he saw a small object creeping up the trunk of the tree. He looked more closely and saw that it was an ant. The ant was carrying a grain of wheat as large as itself. As Tamerlane looked, he saw that there was a hole in the tree only a little way above, and that this was the home of the ant. "You are a brave fellow, Mr. Ant," he said, "but you have a heavy load to carry." Just as he spoke, the ant lost its footing and fell to the ground, but it still held on to the grain of wheat. A second time it tried to carry its load up the rough trunk of the tree, and a second time it failed. Tamerlane watched the brave little insect. It tried 3 times, 4 times, 12 times, 20 times, but always with the same results. You can see in the box, a question for you is what does a dozen mean? Dozen means a measure of unit for certain things, which includes 12 units into it. Then the paragraph reads again. Then it tried the 21st time. Slowly, one little step at a time, it crept up across the rough place where it had slipped and fallen so often. The next minute, it ran safely into its home, carrying its precious load. "Well done," said Tamerlane. "You have taught me a lesson. I too will try again, till I succeed." And this he did. Of what other story does this remind you? Let's move to the question answer session. We'll start with comprehension first. You are given in part A, you have to write true or false against the sentence which is given there. There are 4 sentences. I'll be reading them one by one. Tamerlane was the ruler of Tartary. Is it true or false? So this is written in the first paragraph. Tamerlane was the ruler of Tartary. It's true. Tamerlane could not defeat any enemy. Tamerlane could defeat so many of his enemies, but finally he failed. And this is false. The ant was carrying a grain of wheat. Of course, the ant was carrying a grain of wheat. So we write true against this sentence. A horse taught Tamerlane a lesson. It was not the horse but a small insect. So this is again false. Part B is there. It writes answer the questions. Question number 1. What did Tamerlane want to do? Like Alexander the Great, Tamerlane wished to become the master of the whole world. So he wanted to conquer the whole world. Question number 2. He had now been a wanderer for 20 days. Who had been a wanderer for 20 days and why? Tamerlane had been a wanderer for 20 days. because his armies were scattered and beaten in the battlefield, and he also had fled from the battle, and his enemies were looking for him. Question number 3. Did the ant succeed in carrying the grain of wheat all the way to its home at first? How many times did it try? Answer to this question is, you're right. No, the ant didn't succeed in carrying the grain of wheat all the way to its home at first. Then part B, how many times did it try? It tried 21 times. Part C, read the lines and answer the questions. Question 1. Suddenly, he saw a small object creeping up the trunk of the tree. Who was he? He was the king of Tartary, Tamerlane. Question part B. What was the small object? The small object was an ant. Then part C of this question. Why was the small object creeping up the trunk of the tree? Answer to this is, the small object was creeping up the trunk of the tree to carry home a grain of wheat. Question B from part C. You are a brave fellow, Mr. Ant. Who was the speaker? Answer is, the speaker was Tamerlane. Part B. Why did he call the ant brave? He called the ant brave because he saw that the ant was carrying a grain of wheat as large as itself. Question C. What did the speaker say after this to the ant? The speaker said, but you have a heavy load to carry. Part 3 from question C. It writes, you have taught me a lesson. And the question that follows is, who said this and to whom? Answer, you write the answer. Tamerlane said this to the ant. Part B of the question, what lesson did the speaker learn? The speaker learns a lesson that one should keep trying again and again till one succeeds. Question C. How did the speaker learn this lesson? Answer is, the speaker learned the lesson that the small ant was carrying a load into its home, but it failed numerous times, and finally, after making 21 attempts, it succeeded. Question 4 from part C. But at last, his army was beaten. Then the question that followed to this sentence. Question part A. Whose army was beaten? Answer. You're right. Tamerlane's army was beaten. Question part B. What did he do after this? Tamerlane fled alone from the field of battle. And for a long time, he wandered in fear from place to place. Question C that follows. What is the meaning of the word beaten? Answer is, and the meaning of the word beaten here means defeated. Now question number D. Think and answer. These questions are for the students. You have to apply your logic after reading the book. And there are three questions that you are supposed to answer. Question number one is, why did Tamerlane want to be like Alexander the Great? Question number two, which other stories does this tale remind you of? And question number three, what lesson did Tamerlane learn? Next part from this lesson is language in use. Today we'll be talking about the article the. That can be used as an article for a group or for some particular thing. So let's read this paragraph, a sentence. The food looked splendid, but he couldn't take a single bite. What is the function of the word in bold in the sentence given above? So you can see from the above line, the is written in bold letters as compared to rest of the letters in the sentence. Then you see also letter A is given, it's also bold. So what's the function of the words in the bold in the sentence given above? And the is a definite article and is used before a singular noun which stands for a group. So this can be better explained with the help of an example. As it says, the is a definite article. You have to remember that the is a definite article and is used before a single noun which stands for a group. Any single noun that stands for a group, so we use the as a definite article to represent the group. Example is, the traveler should be ready for everything. Then example 2 follows, the panda is an extremely rare animal. So in the sentences given above, we are not talking about a single traveler or a single panda. Here traveler means all travelers taken together as a group, and panda means all pandas. Other examples are the bear, the snake, the guitar, the tourist, the customer. So can you try making one sentence for these examples? Let's take the one bear. The bear lives in jungle. Then one more, the snake. The snake is a poisonous. Is a poisonous reptile or animal. The guitar is an instrument of music. Likewise, you can write for these two examples, the tourist and the customer. Then here you follow, like, fill in the blanks with a, an, or the. Whatever we understood from this discussion, where we had to use the, where we had to use a. Dash camel is called the sheep of the desert. So should we use a or the? Because the camel is representing the whole camels in the world, and it's not just individually representing itself. We write, the camel is called the sheep of the desert. Then, I rode on dash camel the last time I went to the seaside. So because this is only one camel we are talking about, not the group of the camels or the whole camels. So for this, we'll write, I rode on a camel the last time I went to the seaside. Dash, cactus needs very little water to live. Question is that, is it only one cactus that needs little water, or all the cactus need little water to live? Because we're talking about the all cactus, so this is a group that is being represented here, and this cactus actually stands for the group of cactuses. So we'll write, the cactus needs very little water to live. Then part 4 is, I have dash big potted cactus at home. Here in this example, it talks about a big potted cactus, means only one cactus. So we'll write, I have a big potted cactus at home. Part 5. Dash dash, rainforest is home to many kinds of plants, birds, and animals. Here again, we are talking about the rainforest. A rainforest is a home to many kinds of plants, birds, and animals. Let's look at the another use of the. As I told you in the beginning of article, that the can be representative of the group. We can also use it for individual things or persons. We know that is also used when we are talking about a particular person, thing, or an animal. In the exercise below that follows, you are supposed to write G in the blanks where the shows a group, and P where the particularly where the particularly shows someone or something. I hope you understand. So we have to write G if it is representing the group, because in every sentence that follows, every sentence begins with the, and you have to understand if it is being followed by something which is representative of a group, or it is individually representing someone or something. So question part one is, the sparrow is a very curious bird. Is it general or for a group, or it's for some particular thing or someone? Sparrow, we are talking about the whole sparrows. The sparrow is a very curious bird, means all sparrows are very curious birds. So write G. This sentence here, we see the sparrow is the representative of the group. Then part two, the sparrow kept pecking at the mirror. One sparrow is pecking at the mirror. So this is something which is particularly representing something or someone. So one sparrow is being represented here. So we'll write P. Then part three, the television was invented by John Logie Baird. The television was invented by John Logie Baird. So it's not only one television was invented, means all the televisions, they were actually invented by someone. So here is also about a group. Switch off the television, please. When we talk about switching off a television, means this is particularly someone, some single television that is being talked here. Part five, the goat will eat almost anything. So is it only one goat, or all the goats can eat anything? Almost all the goats eat anything. The goat is jumping over the fence. Here again, this is for a particular goat which is jumping over the fence. And for the above part five, it was the group of goats which can eat anything, and there we wrote G. Part seven, the flute is one of the oldest musical instruments. It's not only one flute. If we take any flute, even if it is a newly made, but it belongs to a group which is one of the oldest musical instruments. So here we'll write G against part seven. Please hand me the flute. I want to play it. Again here, the flute, and I want to play it, means one particular flute is there. So we'll write P for it. The dolphin is a very intelligent animal. Here again, we're talking about the group of things which is very intelligent. So here again, we'll be using G. Let's turn to page number 46, and this work is for you students. I'm sure that you will be trying to seek the help of your parents in attempting on these questions. It talks about the word power, so we will be talking about one example here. We add er or or at the end of some words to form the new words. Example given, bank. If we add er, it becomes banker, means a new word is formed. Bank is an institute where we do the transaction, money transaction, and banker is the person Who works there? Likewise, you are given the word teach. If we add er to it, it becomes teacher. And the teacher is the person who is doing this profession. Likewise, you are given word act. If we add or to it, it becomes a new word actor. Act and actor are two different words with different meanings. Likewise, you are given sale, S-A-I-L, sale. If we add or to it, it becomes sailor. Two new words are being formed by adding or or er to above examples. Likewise, you are given below. You have to cross check it with dictionary. You can also use Google to find the appropriate words. You are given sprint, jail, inspect, conduct, bowl, report, collect, and pant. So you have to see whether er or or is added to make a new word, like inspect, inspect. Should we use or or er? You have to see for bowl, b-o-w-l, er or or. So you have to check it with the Google, or you can also check it with the help of a dictionary. Then part B talks about synonyms. Write two more such words that are formed by adding the suffixes er or or, and read the following words. Rich. We can have alternate word for rich as wealthy or well off. If we have rich as one word, so similarly we can have another word with the same meaning, wealthy or well off. Likewise, peaceful. The other word for peaceful is calm or quiet. So the words which have similar meanings are known as synonyms. Below again is a box in part C. You are supposed to choose the correct words from the box to complete the table below. You are given uneven, strange, accept, shine, reject. Sparkle means to shine or shimmer. So if we can see from above, five words given, sparkle is shimmer. It also means shine. Part 2 is wired. Wired means unusual, which is not common, means strange, something different you don't know. Coarse means rough. And what can be the another word for coarse? Rough and it is uneven, which is not regular. Deny. Part 4 is deny. Deny means to refuse. When you refuse something means you reject something. And then last one is confess. Confess means you admit something. Confess, admit, and accept. Thank you, dear students. I hope you'll be safe at your home. Please be careful. Don't waste your time. This is a time you can work a lot to improve your reading skills, writing skills. Just go through the books, and as teachers are working a lot to provide you with the material so that you work on it at home, and we're expecting that you try to learn all the lessons which are being shared with you on daily basis. And with this, I take your leave. Assalamu alaikum.